Microsoft Excel can be used to view and enter data in Microsoft Dynamics 365 for finance and operations. In this video, we'll show you how to create a new Excel template and then use the template to view and enter data in a header and line pattern. However, before we proceed, you must make sure that the version of Excel that you're using is at least 16.0.6868.2060. If you have an older version, you must update it. For instructions, see the Troubleshoot the Office Integration topic on docs.microsoft.com. Start Excel and create a new blank workbook. To enable the workbook to communicate with finance and operations, you must first install an add-in. Click the Insert tab. Click Store. Search for Dynamics. Click Add next to Microsoft Dynamics Office add-in. The add-in now appears on the right side of the Excel window. You must now add server information to connect to finance and operations. Excel has now established a connection with finance and operations. We'll now design a template for viewing and entering purchase orders. In the Data Connector pane, click Design to turn on Design Mode. Click Add Fields. Select the Purchase Order header table so you can add the header fields. Click Next to view the list of fields that you can add. There are a few things that you must understand before you add the fields. First, you must add all fields that make up the primary key. These fields have a key symbol beside them. Second, you must also add the purchase order number field, even if a number sequence will be used to automatically number purchase orders. The purchase order number field is required because Excel must have all the information that's required in order to successfully create a purchase order in finance and operations. Even if you don't plan to create purchase orders by using Excel, it's still a good idea to add the purchase order number field from a functional perspective. Third, because we're designing the header part of the template, you must lay out the fields in a vertical manner, not in a horizontal grid-like manner. Therefore, you must choose a cell in the workbook for the label of the field and an adjacent cell for the value. You'll do this for every field that must be added. Let's look at how we can add a field. Select cell A1 for the label of the data area. Select cell B1 for the value of the data area ID field. Repeat this process for every other field that you want to add to the header. After you finish adding fields, you can complete the design of the header for this template. Click Refresh to fetch data from finance and operations. The workbook retrieves the first purchase order that was created across all legal entities in finance and operations. Later in this video, we'll look at how to bind templates to legal entities. This is a good time to make sure that the formatting of the purchase order number field is set to text. If it isn't, you must change it to text. We must now add support for purchase order lines. In the Data Connector pane, turn on Design Mode. We must now add the purchase order lines table as a child table to the header. Click the double plus sign button next to the purchase order header data source. The Data Connector app automatically selects the purchase order lines table. Click Next to see the list of fields that are available for lines. Select a cell as a starting point to lay out the grid for the lines. As before, you must add the primary key fields. Because the fields will be laid out in a grid-like manner, you just have to select a field. After you've finished, the lines grid appears in the workbook. Click Refresh to fetch the lines that correspond to the purchase order. Save this template to your computer. As the user who created this template, you can continue to use the template to view existing data and add new data. However, you might also want to make the template available to other users in your organization. Let's quickly see how we can do this in Finance and Operations. In Finance and Operations, in the Common module, open the Document Templates page. This page lists all the Excel templates that are available out of the box in Finance and Operations. We'll add the template that you just created to this list. Click New to begin the process. Click Browse to select and upload the template that you saved to your computer earlier. By default, this template will be available on the Open in Office menu on the Purchase Orders List page for all legal entities in Finance and Operations. However, if you want to make this template available to a specific legal entity only, you can select the specific company checkbox and then select the legal entity. Note that if you want multiple legal entities, but not all of them, to have access to this template, you can make copies of the template, upload the copies individually, and then link each copy to a different legal entity. In this way, you can control the scope of visibility for a template. By default, the template is available to all countries and regions. Therefore, the template will always appear on the Open in Office menu on the Purchase Orders List page, regardless of the country or region codes that are enabled in Finance and Operations. However, if you want to limit this template to a specific country or region code, you can associate it with a country or region by selecting the Specific Country or Region checkbox and then selecting the country or region. If the template must be associated with multiple countries or regions, but not all of them, follow the same process of making copies of the template. By default, the template is available to any user language. Therefore, the template will always appear in the Open in Office menu on the Purchase Orders List page, regardless of the language that's selected on the User Options page in Finance and Operations. However, if you want to limit this template to a specific language only, you can associate it with a language code by selecting the Specific Language checkbox and then selecting the language code. If the template must be associated with multiple languages, but not all of them, you can follow the same process of making copies of the template. After you've added the template, it appears on the list page. Switch to the specific company that the template was associated with and open the Purchase Orders List page. On the Open in Office menu, you'll see that the new template is available for use. If you don't see the template on the Open in Office menu, make sure that your language setting and the country or region codes that are enabled in Finance and Operations match the settings for the template. This brings us to the end of this presentation. We hope you found this information useful. Thank you for watching.